Hi, my name is Frankie Romeo. I'm a graduate student in exercise and nutrition science at Lipscomb University, as well as a certified personal trainer. In this video, I'm going to show you a HIIT routine. But first, let me get down to some of the basics and benefits. HIIT, or high intensity interval training, is a type of circuit training that combines bursts of intense activity with set rest periods. There are many physiological advantages, including it spikes your metabolism, increases muscle tone, and helps your body process lactic acid to minimize the burning sensation in your muscles during and after workout. Not to mention it's time efficient, as most HIIT routines don't last more than 30 minutes. When creating your own HIIT routine, choose exercises with minimal setup time that require little to no equipment. In a gym setting, people are going to be using machines, and they might wonder why you keep coming back to use them again and again and again. With that in mind, here's my HIIT routine for you. You have either 30 seconds or 1 minute for each exercise, depending on the difficulty. Perform as many repetitions as possible in the allotted time without sacrificing proper technique. Notice each rest period is 30 seconds with the exception of the last, which is 3 minutes. This gives you time for water and recovery before repeating the circuit 2 more times. This workout will take about 25 minutes. It starts with mountain climbers. Begin in a push-up ready position with knees off the ground and hands below your shoulders. Make sure your hips are neutral so that your back forms a straight line. Bring your right knee toward your chest, then return it to the starting position while bringing your left knee toward your chest. This should be a quick, alternating movement. An easier alternative is jumping jacks. Stand with feet together and arms at your sides. Hop your feet apart and simultaneously swing your arms overhead. Hop your feet back together and swing your arms back to your sides. Next, toe touches. Lie flat on your back with knees bent and feet on the ground. Extend your knees to bring both feet into the air. Legs should be straight with feet above your hips. Bring your hands into the air above your head with arms straight. Try to avoid moving your legs and feet while performing a crunch by bending your torso, reaching your hands towards your feet, hence the toe touch. Maintain the extended leg and arm position throughout the exercise. If it is too difficult to keep your legs straight in the air, perform crunches instead. Lie flat on your back with knees bent and feet crossed in the air. Cross your arms over your chest. Perform a crunch by bending your torso until your elbows touch your knees. Try to keep your neck relaxed to avoid unwanted strain. Third, jump squats. Stand with feet no closer than shoulder width apart. With arms in front of you, push your hips back before bending your knees and lowering to the ground. Let your arms come to your sides, then swing them up while simultaneously extending your knees and exploding out of the squat into the air. Avoid bringing your knees together throughout the movement. Land carefully with slightly bent knees before the next repetition. Perform standard squats if you want to maintain good form. Perform the same movement, but avoid leaving the ground for better control. Then come hip bridges. Lie flat on your back with knees bent and feet on the ground. Arms can lie at your sides. Push through your heels so that your hips come into the air. This should create a straight line from your neck to your knees. Squeeze your gluteal muscles or buttocks before returning to the ground. Lastly, push-ups. Arms are straight with hands below your shoulders. Legs are straight and hips are neutral so that your backside forms a straight line. Only your hands and feet are touching the ground. Bend your arms and bring your chest towards the ground. Once your chest comes within a few inches off the floor, press with your arms to bring your body back to the starting position. Maintain a straight line with your backside throughout the movement. Some may perform knee push-ups instead. Follow the same technique, but with your knees on the ground instead of your feet for less resistance.
I hope you enjoyed this HIIT routine. While workouts like these encourage you to push yourself, remember quality always comes before quantity. Thanks for watching.